cyclone Black Lever into the closer to the coast of Tamil Nadu and Puducherry.
On Cyclone Nivar that has made landfall, the very severe cyclonic storm Nivar has now weakened into...
What started like just another cyclone that was going to hit Puducherry turned out to be one of the most challenging, a very severe cyclonic storm that the Union Territory has ever faced. Nivar made landfall at Puducherry at a speed of 110 to 120 kilometers per hour, registering the highest rainfall in the history of Puducherry, causing various massive damages, but thankfully no loss of life. 2020 hasn't been very kind, not to mention the pandemic challenge that we have braved through. But these challenges have been building stronger communities, a more efficient government, and wiser citizens headed by a dynamic leader full of valor, strength, and genuine care for his people.
The Bay of Bengal frequently has cyclones forming, mostly around the month of November and May. On 23rd November, the Indian Meteorological Department cautioned that a very severe cyclonic storm, Nivar, which originated in southwest of Bay of Bengal, was moving towards the northwest direction, crossing through Tamil Nadu and Puducherry. On such a warning, the Chief Minister of Puducherry, Mr. V. Narayan Sami, immediately took all the measures needed to combat the situation. A meeting was held between our Honorable Chief Minister and the Honorable Prime Minister of India, where the PM assured that the central government will indemnify the losses incurred by Puducherry due to Cyclone Nivar. Following that, a meeting was held by the CM of Puducherry with the concerned departments.
Being mindful of his people, the Honorable Chief Minister of Puducherry announced the implementation of Section 144 on 24th November from 9 p.m. to 26th November 6 a.m.
A cyclone is not something new for Puducherry, but a cyclone with a speed of 130 km to 140 km per hour definitely triggers a sense of worry. The CM of Puducherry conducted inspections at various departments like the Electricity Department, Harbour, PWD, etc. He also ensured that the drainages in Puducherry were cleared before the storm. People were asked to stay indoors till the cyclone crosses over.
To save the properties of the fisher folks, their boats and fish nets were shifted to a safe zone before a very severe cyclonic storm approached. The National Disaster Response Force was called to assist the government of Puducherry. Backup generators were prepared to supply uninterrupted electricity across Puducherry, and toll-free helplines were activated in case of emergency. The Chief Minister of Puducherry visited the Emergency Operations Center and inspected the work spot where an efficient team of workers was pruning and cleaning the trees at Anasale.
On 25th November 2020, while storm clouds took over and it rained continuously, while even the trees did not stop swaying, there stood our Honorable Chief Minister, well equipped to ride the storm and chase it right out of Union Territory.
Chief Minister of Puducherry, along with his Honorable Ministers, MLAs, Chief Secretary, Secretaries, staff from the Public Work Department, Municipality, Revenue, Law and Order, Electricity Department, Fishery Department, Medical Department, Coast Guards, Department of Risk Management, both State and Centre, and the Army, worked towards keeping the city and the people safe.
Puducherry experienced a continuous rainfall, which started at 8:30 a.m. However, that did not stop our CM from serving his people. The safety of the citizens was his priority. All that he needed for his safety was a raincoat and an umbrella. Police patrols were deployed to make sure that the people of Puducherry stayed indoors and all the shops were closed except for medical shops and dairy booths. For the first time in history, Puducherry has received a 27 centimeter rainfall. The cyclonic winds caused great damage for both villages and town areas in Puducherry. The trees that were thrashed down were cleared off by 8 a.m. the next morning. Though the continuous rain and wind caused a huge loss and damage to the crops and trees in the Union Territory, the safety precautions and measures implemented by RCM safeguarded Puducherry and Karaikal from loss of life during Nivar.
The fierce winds uprooted the trees and toppled electricity pylons, while downpour lashed various parts of Puducherry, causing flash floods. Neither clogged roads nor the partially submerged streets stopped the Honorable Chief Minister from inspecting the low-lying areas. His priority was his people's safety and well-being. Looked like he wouldn't stop at anything. He made his way around the city, inspecting various constituencies, including Rajbhavan, Muthialpet and Kalapet constituency. He also inspected the Emergency Operations Centre on the same day.
On the 26th, CM of Puducherry visited various areas like Nellithup, Thiruppuvanai, Embalam, Bahur, Manavelli, Ariyankuppam, Uppalam and main town areas that included Rajbhavan and Kamaraj Nagar constituencies to make sure that the people were safe.
Now, as the initial inspections have been done, we have come to know that 120-acre crops,
200 hectares of vegetation,
120 hectares of sugarcane, 50 acres of banana plantation and 78 betel leaf plantation have been taken a massive hit in Puducherry. Roads and highways have been damaged as well.
As an initial part of the relief fund, the state government will be requesting 50 crores from the central. An estimate shows that there may be damages to about 400 crores due to Nivar.
Steve Jobs once said, "The only way to do great work is to love what you do." It is very evident that our Honorable Chief Minister, Mr. V. Narayanasamy, does not hesitate to do what is best for his people, and neither would he hold himself back from asking the central government aid for the welfare of his people. Our sincere thanks to all the ministers, the government administrative department staffs and the public for their cooperation with the Honorable Chief Minister of Puducherry. We thank and acknowledge the relentless work done by the disaster management team in restoring Puducherry back to its normalcy.